For question number three, the correct option is option number three. And to show the steps of solution, first of all, let us note down the important data given in the question. For the body, its mass m is equal to 10 to the power minus 2 kg. Experiences a drag force, a frictional force given by the expression F is equal to minus kv square. That is a proportionality constant, and the question is to find out the value of this k. We are also given that initially at t is equal to 0, initial velocity of the body is v0, that is 10 meter per second, and at a later time, t is equal to 10 seconds. Under this drag force, the kinetic energy of the body, I am calling it Kf, that is K final, that falls down to a value of 1 by 8 mv0 square. So we shall need this data or information at the right time. You are supposed to find out this value of this K in this drag force expression. So in step number one, if you look at these different options given, they have got different units for K. So you can try out first dimensional analysis to find the dimension of K, unit of K, and see if that's unique, you'll be getting the solution straight away without any more headache. So looking at the expression, you can see that the dimensional formula of K should be the dimensional formula of F by dimensional formula of V square. The dimensional formula of F is ML T to the power minus 2. Dimensional formula of V is L into T to the power minus 1. So you keep inside square brackets and take the square of that, because it's V square. It's coming out to be ML T to the power minus 2 divided by L square into T to the power minus 2. T to the power minus 2 is cancelling out, and we are having, this is M into L to the power minus 1. The dimension of K is M L to the power minus 1. The corresponding unit should be kg per meter, isn't it? And looking at the options, you can see that both the options 1 and 3 have this unit. So we didn't hit the jackpot. If we got a unique option having the unit of kg per meter, we could get the solution then and there, and no need for any further approach. But we are getting two options, 1 and 3 in the question. They are showing a unit of kg per meter. Therefore, we choose now between options 1 and 3. So in our next step, we shall make use of the fact that kinetic energy after 10 seconds becomes 1 upon 8 mv0 square, written somewhere here. So you can write it, final kinetic energy Kf by initial kinetic energy Ki, that is at the beginning t is equal to 0. Formula for kinetic energy is half mv square, so you can write Kf is equal to half m v square, and initial kinetic energy is half m v0 square, isn't it? They've given initially at time t is equal to 0 velocity was v0, that's why half m v0 square. Finally, I'm calling velocity to be v, so half m v square. So this ratio, well, Kf value was given to be 1 upon 8 m v0 square. Denominator kept as it is, half m v0 square. At the halves cancelling out, m's cancelling out. Here you can see that mv0 square cancelling out. This 1 upon 8 by 1 by 2. This is coming out to be 1 by 4. You can verify I'm getting final velocity square by initial velocity square. V square by v0 square that I'm getting to be 1 upon 4. It follows from here, velocity v at time 10 seconds, that is initial velocity v0 by 2. That's an important equation for me. I'm calling it equation number 1. So you got that velocity of this particle at 10 seconds is half the velocity, or you can call it speed, v0 at initially, that is t is equal to 0. Next, for the motion of this particle under this drag force, we can write this equation of motion by Newton's second law. That is step number 3. Applying Newton's second law, you can write down the force on the body, F is equal to m into A, and is given that the force is minus kv square, as noted here. This is equal to, let us write acceleration derivative form as dv dt. This is a differential equation involving two variables. One is v, the velocity, other is the time, that is t. So separating the variables next, we can write that k by m dt. Let me check once again. M is brought to the left, so k upon m into dt, that is equal to minus dv upon v square. Now once separate the variables, let us integrate both sides between respective limits. On left hand side, initial time is 0, final time is t, that is 10 seconds. Right hand side, integrate, initial velocity is v0, final velocity is called v. As we integrate, left hand side is coming out to be simply k by m into t, that's easy. Right hand side, let me show it somewhere here quickly, that for this indefinite integral, integration of dv upon v square, can write this as v to the power minus 2 to dv, and by standard formula this is coming out to be v to the power minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1. This is giving me minus 1 upon v. So coming back here on the right hand side, we are getting minus, then inside square brackets, minus 1 by v, square bracket closed, the limits written outside, v0 to v. Just follow my steps. There are two minuses, so it becomes plus. I could write 1 by v, kept within square brackets, limits written outside. That is giving me 1 upon v, minus 1 upon v0. We already established here, equation number 1, v is v0 by 2. So, 1 by v is coming out to be 2 by v0 minus 1 by v0. That is giving me 1 by v0. Eventually, I'm getting that kt by m is equal to 1 by v0. We're looking for k here. Well, some steps have gone out of sight, but no problem for us. We already know the correct option is option 3. So I have got kt by m is equal to 1 by v0. So picking up from here, I can write down that, let me write it once again, kt by m, that is 1 by v0. It follows therefore that k is equal to m by v0 into t. Putting numerical data next, the mass of the body that was given to be 10 to the power minus 2 kg, denominator v0 first, that was given to be 10 meter per second, and time t was given to be 10 seconds. So k is coming out to be 10 to the power minus 4 kg per meter, which is option 3. So this is the correct answer, and this corresponds to option number 3, and that is our final choice.